How's it going, everyone? My name is Clink, and welcome back to Demon's Souls. So this is gonna be the second to last part. We're gonna do King's Tower today. I've done really everything in all the other areas I want to, but I am gonna go on ahead and use Ashraya's soul here, since it's the only way I'm really gonna get enough souls for another level, and I don't have anything else I'm actually gonna use it for. You can see a lot of souls at the very least. But these are probably gonna be the final stats for the run. Maybe I'll get another level, maybe I won't, because once you defeat King Allant here, there's no going back, and you can't level anymore. So let's just get into it. This is not a very long level, but it does start out pretty difficult. The start of it's probably the hardest part, if I'm being honest, because you have to basically refight the three bosses of Boletaria right here as NPCs. Because this is who they really are. You have the Tower Knight, the Penetrator, and the Phalanx is actually an archer. She commanded the Phalanx, but the goal is to draw them out one at a time. You can usually get the Penetrator on his own pretty easily. Really, the only one of these that is a threat even on their own is the Tower Knight. But I'm gonna see if I can't lure them out. The problem with the other two is that the archer, I forget her name, it's not actually Phalanx, but you do actually get to see their names, is that even though she's closer, but then she stays further away because, well, she has that freaking bow. Oh no, there's both of them aggroed onto me. Her bow, I think it's the white bow. It does a lot of damage. We already found the white bow in the ritual path. But I'm kind of going to stick back here in hopes that I don't get hit by her too much. So, like I said, the Tower Knight here is the real star of the show. As you can see, he just took out half of my health bar with ease, really. The main hope is to be able to just get behind him, give him a nice backstab, and hopefully you can take him down with only a couple of those. Looks like two of them is all I'm going to need. Problem is just getting behind him again. Come on, go for a stab. There we go. That's what I need. What? Ooh. That's not good. And he has that spear too, which really isn't helping. Gotcha. Okay. I usually end up dying fighting these three, but well, I mean, I still could, because we got one more. But there's another tower shield if you can pick up the one underneath the Lord's Path that you can get from the Tower Knight's arena. Dodge that. Hello, how you doing? Not too much of a match against my strength weapons. Well, there's that encounter done. And in fact, I got so many souls from that, I think I am going to level up some more. So let's actually go back and do that. Did go ahead and use the four-storied warrior souls that I had, so we can go on ahead and get up to level 83. I hit that 40 strength mark that I wanted, so these are definitely going to be the final stats for the run, I think. Yeah, let's continue forward. Edoke. So yeah, this level is really short, honestly. We'll probably be done in, you know, I'd say about 5 or 6 minutes, really. It's a small tower climb, but the main thing is there's going to be another NPC encounter at the end that we have to get through. The boss and level aren't the only things I'm going to do today. We're actually going to go and get the Demon Brant. So I haven't really talked about the Demon Brant and Old King Doran. We'll get a little bit of a lore dump on them soon-ish. So I won't talk about them too much, but it's coming up. And hello, Mr. Red Knight. Yeah, there's knights just guarding the tower, which you would expect. Come on, buddy. I think there's two or three that we're gonna have to kill, and as you can see, these are still a decent bit stronger than the ones in the inner ward. This is probably the hardest chunk of the level here, because there's an Imperial spy that we got to deal with. Uh-oh. Don't want to let him be off the ground for too long. And hey there, buddy. Pancakes. Okay. That's pretty much the bulk of the enemies. I think there's a fat official or two that we're going to deal with here in a minute, but it's not too big of a deal. Bye. That really muffled for some reason. Is there an item up there? Nope. Alright, so we're good then. Up to the top. I'm pretty sure that the item up there, we'll get that here in a bit, because there's actually a shortcut. But we first got to deal with the dragon Bior told us about. This is the blue one that you could see in level 1 that I just never showed, but he's here for the end of the game. To my knowledge, you cannot use poison cloud on this one. You have to shoot it down with bows and arrows. This one's a lot more annoying to kill than the red one. I will not be killing it, but you can do so should you wish. So we're gonna walk out on the bridge. We're gonna let him breathe his fire and burn that fat official to a crisp. I recommend letting him do his flames a couple times to kill it. That way you don't have to dodge his fireballs. It's not too hard, but it's kind of annoying. It's mildly annoying. Should be fine right here once the fire's gone. Run, run, run. We have lots of endurance for this. And he's gonna shoot a fireball in my back. Yep. Dang. Hopefully things go better this time. Get going. I want him to speed fire on this side again. Okay, him doing the jump attack is a lot better than him charging up a fireball immediately. I usually don't get hit going across this bridge. I don't know why it's happening today. I'm glad I at least have the vitality to tank it, though. And we'll run back across that bridge here in a second. If you did not want to spend 20,000 souls on a knight sword with the Dregling Merchant, you can actually get a free one right here. I think there's also a knight shield. Yeah. So that's pretty cool. Like I said, Night Sword is a great weapon if you put that crushing path on it. This lever to open this door right here, we're not in the original game. There was not a shortcut at all on the PS3 version. At least with this, you get a very minor shortcut and the Blue Eye Knight Greaves. I think I found everything but the helmet. I don't remember where the helmet's at. But we head over this way. We got to get past the dragon one more time. The way I recommend doing things is wait for him to be breathing backwards and then run this way, because he actually won't hit the right side here. And he will actually hit down here, I think, if you sit here for long enough. I'm willing to take that risk, though. Because two legendary hero souls, kind of worth it. Or was it? No, it is two. So that's 20k.
Oh, it's you, is it? My father is up above. Well, something like him anyway. A demon in his shape. I began this quest to ask my father his reasons. To drag him back to the path of righteousness. But it seems it was all in vain. Please, kill my father. In his depraved state, he can only bring peril to these lands. This key opens Boletaria's mausoleum. Inside the mausoleum lies Father's sword, the Demon Brand, twin of Soul Brand. Use it to bring an end to his madness.
So a very thematic end to this game would be if you took this mausoleum key and you went and got the Demon Brand, because King Allant up here will have the Soul Brand. They're two parts of a whole that make the Northern Regalia. The Demon Brand is a weapon meant for slaying demons, and the Soul Brand is one that harvests the power of souls obtained from humans. When Allant was in his frenzy, he had a choice between the two, and he picked the Soul Brand, so he chose to turn his back on humanity, and then awoke the old one to side with the demons. By the way, we have to kill Estrava as a Black Phantom now that he's dead. Probably one of the saddest parts of the game. I feel like I kind of just threw that under the bus a little, but like, yeah, this part it kind of sucks that you gotta do this. You literally see him die, and then moments later, you get your final NPC encounter of the game. There's a part of me that still wants to just go back and level up, but I think I'll go on ahead and just do the boss. You can finally get his rune sword and shield, should you wish, and... Nah, it's not worth it. Let's just go do it. So you have the longest elevator ride in existence up until Elden Ring, probably. If you die, you do have to redo this elevator ride, and if you dilly-dally too long at the top, you will have to redo this elevator ride. Because it doesn't stay up at the top, it'll come back down after a couple seconds, but... this elevator ride's actually like a minute or two long. It's kind of crazy. So... yeah. It's pretty slow, but... creates a lot of tension in the build-up as you go up to Allant here. Which is quite fun, quite interesting. I like it a lot, actually. It is kind of annoying on the rerun, but... that very first time as you... just have to anxiously await what you might encounter here at the top is pretty cool. Here we go. There it is, the Soul Brand. We're gonna go ahead and slap on Curse Weapon. So old King Allant here, he is definitely one of the harder fights in the game. He is aggressive, he is fast, he is deadly. It is a straight on duel. Unfortunately, his AI is quite cheesable. You get in a couple hits and then you back away and and he'll always do this charge attack, really. And then you can just go in and get some hits if you just start hitting him from behind. Half the time, when you're close, he'll do that attack there. You can stun him out of that. I'm not really gonna try to fool with it. It has a pretty long range, but once he does that, he'll almost always follow it up with this attack still, so you can just do the same thing and get in a couple hits. That right there is a soul suck ability. He'll actually take away a soul level if he hits you with that. But that's also how we got to max level around launch. It was kind of funny. And I don't think I brought any age spices with me, so I'm not gonna be able to use curse weapon for the rest of the fight, but that's fine. My damage is honestly pretty good having so much strength. At this point, I would probably just level Dexterity, believe it or not, since this does have an S scaling with Dexterity, so it'd give me about the same bonuses as leveling Strength up to 40, because 40 is usually about the soft cap in Souls games for a stat. You never really have to level them higher than 40 unless it's a magic stat, in which case 50 is usually about where they cap out, or at least the tangible benefits of them do, at least. But. Yeah, this fight, Once Upon a Time, was definitely a very intense duel in the series, but nowadays it's nothing crazy compared to what FromSoft's put in some of their later releases, but I still quite like Old King Allant. I think it's a pretty fitting end for the game. It's a good boss to really end a main playthrough on, at least. I'll actually try to take him on a little bit here. Oh, I forgot that had a projectile. Oh, there's the Soul Suck. I don't remember if the Soul Suck is an instant kill or anything. I don't think so. Ooh, that did a lot of damage, actually. Jeez. There we go.
How did you defeat my demonic reflection? How many souls might you have devoured, I wonder? The rest is up to the old one. If it is to be, then you shall be beckoned.
Yeah, that was none other than a false image constructed by Allant. That was more Allant in his prime. The Allant that we will see soon enough is not nearly the same, and I'm actually going to go to the Nexus and, you know, go into soul form, so I'll be right back. And I'm actually just going to go up to Mausoleum, it's the thing up there. You know, I kind of forgot there's a cutscene here, so we're actually going to watch this real quick. Okay, there we go. Okay, I don't believe this has any ties to your world tenancy or anything. You just need the mausoleum key. So this is like where you go in and you met Ashrava just down this staircase. So this is the boulder that came down and I just came out from the first shortcut of the Gates of Boletaria here. So the mausoleum is essentially old King Doran's grave. Doran was the king that kind of was Boletaria's rise to power was with him after the first scourge. I don't remember if he was a warrior within the first scourge or not, but he's essentially been long dead, and he wielded the Northern Regalia, his extremely powerful, you know, greatsword. So we're gonna go meet him and see what's up once we get past this Red Knight. So you could have fought this in the very first level if you want to. I didn't come over here because I knew I would probably die to it. So I just left it be, honestly. But you want to head and open the door? I'm actually going to go on ahead and do this.
Thou who seekest the king's sword. I am the old king. Show me thy strength and the power of thy soul.
So, old King Doran here will be resurrected with a thanks to the Scourge and whatnot. He's wielding the Northern Regalia. He is pretty tough. You have to beat him in some combat in order to be worthy of the Demon Brand. And be very careful. He can be either hyper-aggressive or very passive, depending on his mood. You don't have to get him close to death or anything. Yeah, it's like just a little bit of damage and eventually he'll say you're worthy. You might notice those green particles on him. That's because he has a stamina regen ring on, and if you can fully take him out, you will be rewarded with it. It is a duel I do not recommend you take directly. It's a very tough one. In fact, it'd probably be the hardest fight in the entire game if you did that. Because I didn't take as much damage there as I thought I would have. It's kind of shocking, actually. There we go.
To have impressed one such as me, young knight. I am old King Doran, and thou hast proven thy strength to me. Step forth and take the king's sword in thy hand.
So yeah, if you came here first and you grabbed the Demon Brand, you could potentially, you know, level it up or whatever and have the stats to wield it. And defeat Allant with it. It'd be pretty fitting, honestly. A white blade made to be wielded against demons held for generations by the Boletarian royal family, paired with his counterpart Soulbrant to form the Northern Regalia. The less demonic the soul of the wielder, the more powerful this blade becomes, hence old King Allant's choice to wield Soulbrant instead. I think this has to do with your character tendency. It's either character or world tendency. If it's pure white, this is stronger. And since we have mostly pure white stuff, or at least close to it, by the way, I strongly recommend you be in pure white or at least neutral going into New Game Plus. It'll make your life a lot easier. If you want to get the ring, though, for Old King Doran, all I recommend you do is just cast Poison Cloud. It'll deal with him. He'll aggro onto you with the poison at some point, I do believe. But if that happens, you can just walk away. He won't be able to really go past this building here, so if you just go back on that bridge, he won't do much. Other than that, you just sit here until he dies. So I'm going to do that. It's a little cheesy, I know, but it's a pretty tough duel. And if you just want the ring, this is the best way to do it. And this is the last one I'm going to get, so I'll be back once that's done. Okay, I just want to point out, I'm getting proven wrong a little. He's coming out here pretty far. It looks like he's kind of having some problems here. It's kind of funny, actually. Curious just what happens if I backstab him. I think he's just stuck in this corner, because I don't think he's technically supposed to get over here. That's, very interesting. I'm going to be very careful about this. I don't want him attacking me. This, in combination with the poison, really helps out, actually. Are you gonna get mad from over there, old man? Maybe? We gonna do this song and dance again? That's your plan here? Oh, nope, he got tired. Turning around, running away. There we go. Okay, so yeah, upon killing him, you'll be rewarded with none other than his armor and the Eternal Warrior's Ring. This is essentially the Chlorinthy Ring from Dark Souls. Increases stamina recovery speed. Really good, really cool. I'm going to use it for the end game. But yeah, with that, we are done. Next time, we're going to go meet the Old One and finish the game. So I will see you guys then. Bye-bye.